finalist for the group competition. Three hoops and two pairs of clubs, and look at the lineup. Look at what we've got to enjoy. Some absolutely fantastic teams about to take to the field of play. This one is going to keep us guessing. Will it be Italy like it was in the single apparatus? Who knows? Who knows? Japan get us underway in this group 3-2 final. They were the third strongest performers in qualification with 41.6. Intricate finish that is. One can only imagine the focus that is going into the collective mentality of this Japanese group in not being overawed by the occasion and the prospect of what's in front of them at their home Olympic Games, and the extra weight they've had to endure having been in such terrific form at the end of 2019. Together, no apparatus finals, it's an all-around competition. He had a lovely pass with the back leg, so hard to judge the angle. That's a wonderful way to complete the traditional pass of the hoop over the athlete's body.
Anyone selfie? team.
Matsubara, Sakura no Shitani, Sayuri Sugimoto, Ayaka Suzuki and Nanami Takenaka. Next it will be the group from Ukraine, the seventh best performers in qualifying. For Japan, they have dropped down by about a mark and a half in qualifying. Ukraine with another big performance. Their execution in qualification was seventh. They bring that up to the level of their difficulty. This is an interesting routine. The squad of six, Diana Baeva, Mariola Bobnarchuk, Karina Duda, Vera Meneschuk, Anastasia Wozniak and Alina Melnik. Very nearly. It is such an enthralling routine in so many ways. Just didn't quite come together. So, very fine example of partnership. Very hard to stay. evil eyes, that sort of walkover skill assisted in that way. Difficult catch to stabilise, and it's always worse when it happens right at the close of the routine too. Just magnifies that something has not gone right. A somewhat resigned look on their faces. .15 for Ukraine. They dropped by just over 3 marks in their qualification score.
The team of Hungary.
Hungary has done very well to position themselves in this final. The 8 strongest qualifiers. We look at Julia Farkas, Anita Fekete, Nadim Fodor, Mandula Mizaros, Becca Shomhegi and Monica Urban-Sabo. That's the squad of 6, 5 of whom are now competing in the 3-2 final. A tricky situation for Hungary early on in the routine. They essentially had to perform a full system restore of the routine. just get back to a point where they could begin again. Ever so challenging. Some very nice moments in the routine, though. Good partnership. There's a well-controlled and agile catch. Nonetheless, a very positive accomplishment from Hungary to make it into this final, a competitive field. Did very well to relegate the likes of Mexico to first reserve spot. Turkey in this final. For Hungary it is 33.95, so down by almost a full 3 marks from their qualification score. Israel were the bronze medalists in Tashkent with this particular piece. Of Diane, Yana Kramarenka, Natalie Wrights, Yuliana Tanagina and Karen Vexman. such a splendid European Championships, when the title was very much up for grabs at the end of 2020. In a slightly depleted field, it was Israel who really did produce the goods. Keeping that standard going is such a challenge. Fifth strongest in the qualification campaign for this final. Certainly an open field at the moment, but we still have to come Italy, Russia, Belarus, Bulgaria. That's the second half of the competition. There they are, gymnasts who absolutely delivered in the single apparatus final. Israel, it's 41.6, and that means that Israel have got into the gold medal position. Now, can they stay on the podium? That's the challenge with who is left. But they've done very well to displace Japan. It is pretty obvious where the home support lies, with Martina Centofanti, Agnese Durelli, Alessia Marelli, Daniela Longurian, Laura Faris and Martina Santandrea, the team from Italy. Great memories for some of these gymnasts from Pesaro in 2017. I think it is safe to say they rather enjoyed that in the Victory Frigo Arena. I suspect you did watching it at home too. That's a very well put together routine. Intricate and stylish, real flair to the performance. A lot of unsighted work with the apparatus. Isn't that just super, that sequence? Into these combined grand jeté positions. Judiciously placed moments of synchronization. Their score is a huge jump up from the qualification, 44.15. Again, not far off 5 marks. And that certainly puts the pressure on the second strongest qualifiers, the Russian Federation. They tend to be pretty good at answering. The second strongest performers in qualifying, the Russian Federation, Anastasia Maximova, Anastasia Bliznyuk, Olga Karasieva, Karina Metelkova, Angelina Shkatova, and Anastasia Tatarieva. 42.75 their score. not a great challenge to see how they go about accumulating such a high degree of difficulty in that routine. 34.5 was the D score in qualification. There are just so many little flourishes here and there. Hugely experienced gymnast is Maximova. Almost captaining the side from the field of play. Olympic champion in 2016. Italy are on 44.15. Israel 41.6. Japan 40.15. Russia go into second place. 43.2. That's one of Italy's big challenges seen off. They've still got Belarus and Bulgaria to come. Italy have guaranteed a medal. Here is Belarus, fourth strongest performers in qualification. The squad, Anna Hajdukovic, Anastasia Malakhanova, Anastasia Rybakova, Anna Shvaiba, Arina Tsitsilina, and Karina Yarmolenko. And they've got a few fans here. Precision and then a moment where it just got away from them. Oh, it is a busy routine. There are some intricate and playful moments. Some rather breathtaking apparatus passes. That positively routine compared to some of the other things they do. Turns. Belarus' score 40.15. That's a case of what might have been.
Heidi Pilenza, Otulet, Obichan Vismel, Koino, Nasochan, Jedan Bukrat.
So what it means is with one to go, we have Italy, then we have the Russian Federation. And then we have Israel. Bulgaria, the top performers in qualification with 42.8. They will need to go significantly beyond that, though, to maintain top spot. Their squad comprises Simona Zyankova, Stephanie Kiryakova, Madeline Zadochanova, Emilia Stoilova, Laura Triets, and Erika Zafirova. They won the gold in Baku and in Sofia. is going to keep us guessing. Nervous gymnast wait to see what this number will be for Bulgaria. Captivating performance. What a lovely moment that was. Fluid pass. Pace that these gymnasts are working at to pack difficulty into their routines. Some moments where they have to really reach for the apparatus. Huge numbers of them. Before the Olympic Games. This is a big moment. And it is a score that's not quite big enough for Bulgaria. 41.1 for them. And what that means is that it is another goal for Italy. Russian Federation in second place, and Israel, that's a great accomplishment from the European champions to take the bronze ahead of Bulgaria, Japan and Belarus. Well, that has just asked and thrown up more questions than it's answered ahead of the Olympic Games. Fascinating. Now don't go anywhere, will you, because we've got some ceremonies to enjoy now. The victory ceremony for the clubs competition, the ribbon and the 3+2, and then the presentation of all of the medals, or rather all of the winners for the overall World Cup series. So we'll have the all-around individual winner, the all-around group winners, and then the hoop ball